stay true to your customers and true to the art form and just do a good job every time, you'll make it. That's all that stuff. Only the people truly love tattooing will be around to the end. And all the people that just got into it for the fame or the glory, the industry will shed itself on about that in time. Can you give this to me for free?
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, yeah. Back in the day, it used to happen all the time. I ain't had no one pass out in probably 3 or 4 years. But back in the beginning, when I started, you'd have someone pass out 2 times a day.
Really?
Yeah.
You think it had to do with you being new?
No, it had to be because tattooing was still not as big as it is today. And people always worried about what other people would think. They would have their nerves all bent out of shape when they came in. Have someone pass out and go into like a little seizure, mouth seizure. Had someone poop on themselves before.
Yeah.
That was a shitty situation.
Did they let you know or did you figure that out?
Well, he passed out and he went into like a little mouth seizure. You know, we did everything to bring him back. And I guess as soon as he came to, his body just released or whatever, and it was awful stinky, you know. And all his friends were like, oh my god, he just shit himself. And we had to get up, walk him to the bathroom, all his friends made fun of him. Well, we let him go in there and clean up a little bit, whatnot, drink a Coke, get feeling better, and then, yeah, we checked. So you write for the paper, huh?
Yeah.
Do you have any questions or anything, man?
No, I've actually
been here. Can you base this out?
Yeah.
That's wild, isn't it? A lot of interviewing going on in here. So,
I thought that was kind of interesting. You know, he's
interviewing.
Yeah. He's interviewing you, and I'm watching him interview, and I'm going to be interviewing them later.
To be honest, most of our business is young girls. It seems like girls are getting more tattoos than anyone.
There's a bunch of them coming in together.
Yeah, and the average girl probably gets 6 tattoos out. I used to travel around a lot. I got tattoos from Australia, Connecticut, New Jersey.
Oh, Lord,
yeah. Anytime I would go to a different state or travel at a convention, I'd get something.
I even let
my little son Logan do a little tattoo on me. I got a little tattoo of a pig right there on my side. So
that's awesome.
Yeah, your son did it. He was 4 years old.
With it, just a regular gun?
Yeah, and hurt real bad.
Did you help him? That's pretty good.
Oh, he's talented, man. He is unbelievable. He's going to be 10 times the artist I am by the time he's my age. The only time I've ever heard my kid say something, I came home with a tattoo on my face. My little girl said, another one?
Yeah. Well, what about her as far as the art goes?
Yeah, she can draw, but she hasn't really fully got into it yet. She's just doing a little fashion design stuff. She likes drawing dresses and hair, putting certain clothes together. Nowadays, when I do vacations, they're real low-key, laid-back, like going to the beach a lot. Took the kids to Disney World this summer. Got to see the shuttle launch. Yeah, we still mess with that. Some of the guys here still training it, too.
How did you get involved?
Got works here, started training locally, and then I started training a little bit and kind of went into it from there.
Oh, you did some training?
Yeah, I did a little bit, yeah.
Brazilian
jiu-jitsu? Nah. Actually, I have. I went into a tough man competition and got beat up.
Man, my whole view on that is it takes a hell of a man to get his ass kicked.
Yeah, I did get my ass kicked. how when they decided on an amount of money that they needed that would help them out, and then I agreed to it, and then they agreed to wear shirts and promote me anytime they went out of town. I find all of them interesting, you know. Every time someone comes in, it's something totally different. So that's why it keeps us from getting bored, is that people are just constantly coming in with new ideas and pushing us as far as our talent-wise to do something better. Because it gets kind of boring getting in the rut of doing the exact same thing with Tasmanian Devil, yeah, and yeah, Tribal Tattoo. Weezy portions of cars and everything. I've done someone's 70 Chevelle on them. Everything else. Wow.
Weezy portions of people.
Oh, yeah, animals, everything. Yeah, you know, definitely takes a pretty good artist to do something like that. Some people specialize in that, and some people are better at other things, you know. We have, like I said, we have a guy here that works with us named Adrian Wright. He is really, really good portion artist. Haywood decided he wanted to pursue music career other than art, so he actually got a chance to be in an MTV movie coming up.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so he went to film that movie with them and do the music in it, and pretty much just got out of tattooing.
That's awesome. Really? Didn't know nothing about that.
Oh, man, he's like one of the best banjo players in the
country. I'll check him out online.
He's bad.
Yeah, it's crazy, you wouldn't expect it. I mean, I don't know.
We were playing Nirvana songs with banjo, more or less.
Yeah.
That sounds wild.
Yeah, it is wild.
You wouldn't expect the tattoo guy to be playing the
Yeah, because he was like a teacher at U of L, like art teacher.
Oh, yeah.
No, I personally have never had any experiences with it, but I would love to find it and see a ghost. I know I went up to the TV clinic up there and stuff, so like a little haunted tour. But yeah, I'd love to be freaking on. I'd love to see one.
Okay.
No, I don't believe no aliens either. No, but I wish there was a Sasquatch. I'd like to kill one and have it mounted on my wall for the rest of my life. I've always been a Bigfoot fan of my life, yeah. I'd like to see one. I like, every time there's a show that comes on, I'll watch it. I'm all about it. When they do the research and the scientific testing on them, I wish there was one.
That's funny.
Yeah. It's like been one of the biggest things when I was a kid growing up. I always liked some Bigfoot. Definitely jeans and a nice shirt. What would your last meal be if you were on death row?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
What would your last meal be?
Maybe cheeseburger and fries, man. Homemade hamburger.
But it's plain.